Good day and welcome back. We'll talk about diffraction grating. It is about the combination of diffraction and also the interference phenomenon coming from multiple slits. We're going to review the formula and discuss the difference between those phenomena. First of all, we're going to review the diffraction. So this is something that I have discussed before. We have the formula of sine theta equal to lambda over A equal to x over d. From the formula, A is the size of the slit and x is the distance between the central maximum and the first order minimum or the first dark fringe. Next is the interference pattern. We also have similar formula and we do not consider about the angle of diffraction in this topic. This is because that the pattern has fixed value of x. Every dark and bright fringes have the same width. From the formula, the variable A here is the slit separation, which is different from the formula in diffraction pattern. Besides that, the x represents the distance between two consecutive bright fringes or dark fringes. So now we are going to look at the diffraction grating, which is made of multiple slits. The derivation is quite similar, and the variable that we are looking at is the slit separation, which can be obtained by the formula of 1 over n, where n is the number of slits in 1 meter. That is the standard definition for n. We can get the similar triangle as what we have done before. Using the triangle function, we can obtain the equation of optical path difference delta L equal to d sine theta. So we are interested to find about the bright fringes. We are looking for the constructive interference, which requires the optical path difference is m lambda. In short, we have the equation of d sine theta equal to m lambda, where m is the order of maximum. In addition, we can do also the similar approximation like we did before, and we can get the equation of m lambda over d equal to x over d. So here is the summary about diffraction grating. The significant difference compared to the interference pattern is that the bright fringes in diffraction grating pattern has smaller width and higher intensity. Another thing that you can encounter is about the highest order that can be observed. This is limited by the angle of diffraction that sine theta cannot be more than 1. Substitute the sine theta as m lambda over d, we can see that the order m is not more than d over lambda. From here, we can calculate the number of maximum, which is equal to 2m plus 1. Let's try one question from the past year in 2015. A monochromatic light with frequency 6 times 10 power 14 Hz is incident normally on a diffraction grating which has 300 lines per millimeter. Based on the definition of n, we need to convert the unit to lines per meter. So 300 lines per millimeter is equal to 300 times 1000 lines per meter, simple length conversion. The question gave you the frequency of light, and we know that the speed of light in vacuum or in air is 3 times 10 power 8 meter per second. Using the formula of V equal to F lambda, we can get the wavelength of the light is 500 nanometer. Next is the slit separation that D equal to 1 over N, it is equal to 1 over 300,000 meter. First question, determine the angle of diffraction for second order maximum. So we just apply the formula of D sine theta equal to M lambda, where M is equal to 2 in this case. Between the values, the angle is 17.5 degrees. The next question is to obtain the number of maximum produced. So we've discussed about this in the previous slide. The condition is that the value of sine theta cannot be bigger than 1. Rearrange the formula, m is not more than d over lambda. Between the values, the maximum value of m shall be 6. Hence, the number of maximum is equal to 2 times 6 plus 1 equal to 13. We look at one more question from the trial paper of TERENGGANU in 2021. A diffraction grating of 2,400 lines per centimeter is used to produce a diffraction pattern. The first order fringe is at 0.94 centimeter from the central fringe. If the distance between the grating and the detector is 0.625 meter, what is the wavelength of the electromagnetic wave used? So same thing happened here. Remember to convert the n to SI unit that n is equal to 240,000 lines per meter. So the d will be equal to reciprocal of n. The next step is just apply the formula. You can consider to use the lambda over d equal to x over d. Put in the values, we can obtain the wavelength is 596 nanometer. So you can see that there is slight difference in the options provided, which is 590 nanometer. This is because that x over d is coming from the small angle approximation method. If we calculate the angle of diffractions, it is about 8 degrees for the first order maximum. So my opinion here is that the method is still valid for small angle of diffraction, but for higher order of maximum, which has bigger angle, the method is no longer valid because it will have a bigger error. To solve for higher order maximum, or you want to have higher accuracy of answer, you can refer to the answer scheme provided in the Google Drive. To describe the method in general, it used the Pythagoras theorem and the trigonometry function without any approximation. So I'm sure you will have no issue to understand about the steps. If you have, let me know in the comment section. The last thing to discuss is the formation of spectrum of light. This can be produced by taking a beam of white light incident on a diffraction grating. The expected observation is that there is a white line in the center as the central maximum, and then we can observe the spectrum in other order of maximum from the first order until the highest order of maximum. One thing can comment is about the arrangement of the color. This can be explained by the wavelength. Basically, red has the longest wavelength, and based on the formula of sine theta equal to m lambda over d, the longer the wavelength, the bigger the angle of diffractions. So this is why the red light appears at the outer layer of the spectrum. So that's all for my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Leave it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.